Hey, welcome back to Move It Martha. Today we're doing the wreath that I promised with the roses, the little cabbage roses. So I just, I named my channel Move It Martha just because I feel like Martha's not the only domestic diva out there. Us girls deserve some love too. So, I'm going to go over the supplies for the project. I always want to give credit where credit is due. So sometimes the ideas that I come up with and make are my own. And then sometimes they are inspired by other people's blogs or their YouTube channel or something like that. Probably if I saw it on a YouTube channel, I'm not going to replicate it because you guys can just go to the original channel and see it. But if I have seen something in a blog or read it in like a Creating Keepsake magazine or something like that, or I've gotten the recipe for something that I'm baking somewhere, I will always give the credit. So this project I found on a blog called House of Smiths. The lady's blog is really, really lovely. She does a lot of decorating and like refinishing of furniture and, you know, paint swatches and different rooms that she's done. She recently inspired me to renovate my pantry and straighten it out. So she did this idea in like a little ball form, and then she made it in three different size balls, and then she hung them from a ceiling, I think in one of her children's rooms. And although I do love the idea of the little cabbage rose made out of the crepe paper, I wasn't sold on it in the ball form. Maybe if it was going to go on a table in a bowl or something like that, but I just didn't like it hanging from the ceiling. I'm not sure why. But as I scrolled down in her blog, I did notice that she did it in a wreath, and she attached it to a canvas, and then on the bottom she put vinyl on the bottom and it said spring. And again, I wasn't sold on the wreath being glued to the canvas with the wording. I just like the wreath alone separately, and you can like just hang it on your door from like one of those hangers or from a nail. So we're gonna get started. I'm gonna go over the supplies. This is a craft that even children can do. Although it does include a glue gun, if you don't want your children using a glue gun, you can always use glue dots. If you're not familiar with glue dots, they come in all different sizes. They're super, super sticky, especially if you use it on a thin paper like crepe paper. It will really make it stick. I personally am using the glue gun just because it's a little quicker, and I want to get this project done and move on to my baking of my muffins that I promised. So I'm going to go over the supplies, and then wherever the glue gun is being used, you could just note that you could use the glue dots, and I'm sure the project will hold up just as well as a glue gun. So we need a roll of streamers, we need a scissor, some thicker kind of ribbon. I'm picking this. I just like the contrast of black and pink. We need a form of a wreath. I like this wreath because it has a modern shape to it. It's kind of like rounded on the edges versus being square, but you could use the square kind. You could use a green wreath, even though that's from more like of a kind of like the fake flower type of thing. I just like the shape of this, and I like that it's not that big, so it's not going to take that many flowers to fill up, but it still will look really cute. I believe I got this wreath form in Michael's, but I have seen wreath forms at the Dollar Tree, so you could always check there if you're on a budget, and I'm almost positive you could get streamers at the Dollar Tree also, but you might have some left over from a party. Don't we all have some streamers at some point that we used for a project, and then we're like, what are we doing with these three other spools of streamers? This is a lovely, lovely project. It's nice for Mother's Day to hang it on a door. It could go in a kid's room. I think I might hang it on the outside door of my craft room. We'll see. I'm not exactly sure what I will be doing with it. I might give it away as a gift, but we're going to start with the look of the flower. This is how the flower looks. It's kind of like a cabbage rose. And then you just, as you start making a bunch, you just start hot gluing them onto the wreath. So I'm going to put that aside, and then I'm going to go over the process of doing the streamers. I've already pre-cut the streamer. I took my whole spool and just cut the whole spool because I'm probably not going to save a half a spool of streamers if I had any left over. So we're going to take it and we're going to cut it in 24-inch lengths. And then we're going to take it and just crumple it up. And then we're going to flatten it back out. And then we're going to start by simply rolling it in tightly. Once you've got it rolled a few turns, we're going to add a spot of hot glue. Again, if you're doing this with children, you're going to want to use a glue dot. I like to glue it kind of at the top just because we're going to cut this after to make it a little flatter so it fits on the wreath. But if you're gonna use it for a different purpose and you want the flower to be like this deep, then I would glue it down here. But I glued it here because we're probably gonna cut about that much, this much off of it. So I glue it more at the top. So once we get it tightly rolled, now we're gonna loosely roll it. And I like to fold the top out a little bit once I get going with it, just so that it looks a little bit more real. If you just kind of roll it in, you could see it's just kind of like, almost like rolling a cigar or something like that. So I like it to be a little looser, and then I turn the outsides, the top of it, out a little bit. So once we get that kind of rolled, sometimes you have to kind of roll it all in and then roll it out. You just got to play with it a little bit. But I like to just keep it going and then just be real loose with it as you're going. Sometimes I've rolled it all the way and then I've had to unroll it and redo it because it just kind of wasn't falling right. Oops. So you just, once you make one, then you just kind of get on a roll, and making more is not as hard. But what you need to do is, as you're rolling it, see, I rolled a little bit. Now I'm going to unroll it and put another dab of glue. You've got to glue it every so often. Otherwise, when you go to cut it later, it might just all unravel. So you've just got to keep rolling and gluing. Okay, so glue it a little bit more. And sometimes when you're done with the flower, you're like, oy, what does this look like? But I promise you, once you have them all together, they really do look like flowers and not just rolled up streamer paper. It really does start to take some shape and look like a flower, especially when they're put all together. So once you have that all done, you're just going to keep rolling all of the streamers, all your strips, and then you're going to start to glue them on the wreath like I did. I showed you in the beginning, I glued about 5. So maybe make about 5 and then glue some to your wreath and then keep on going like that. And then this way you don't have them all just kind of lingering around. We're almost to the end. And as I'm going along, I'm kind of pushing down because this inside keeps wanting to come up. So I just keep rolling it down and just be real loose about rolling it on the outside so that your flower can get nice and full. Because if you make it too tight, your flower is going to be really kind of like a bud. You want it more like a blossomed cabbage rose. So here I am at the end. I'm just going to put a dab of glue. And I'm going to roll it over. I'm going to let that dry. Then I kind of like to pinch it a little bit. Hope I'm staying in the frame. So I like to pinch it at the bottom. Then I kind of fluff it. Push my center down. And then I take my scissor. And this is where gluing it at the top comes in real handy. Because we're going to cut it down. And see, it doesn't fall apart because I've glued it all around. So then I'm going to glue it to my wreath. And just start filling up my wreath. So I'm going to go ahead and finish all the rest of my flowers. I'm going to get them all rolled and hot glued onto the wreath. And then I'm going to show you the last part of the ribbon and how that's going to hang. So stay tuned and I'll be back in just a minute. All right, so I'm back. I finished all my rosettes. It took a lot of rosettes, but I finally got it done. It is fully complete. I put this little bow on it on the side. I had a difficult time with the bow. I was trying to like hang it from the top here with a long strand to hang it on the door, and I didn't like the way it looked. I kept trying to use like a polka dot ribbon. That really wasn't working for me. So I finally settled on this sheer ribbon that has like a little bit of a silver beaded trim. I think that it makes the wreath more noticeable that the ribbon is a little subdued, because I was trying to use a polka dot ribbon and it kind of was like, although I like polka dot and pink together on this wreath, it was like really clashing. The black was standing out too much. So I like this little understated side bow. I first originally put it on the bottom, but I didn't like it there. I felt like it wasn't grounded. It was just like glued on. It wasn't like, it didn't look like secure. So then I moved it to the side here, which I kind of like it. It's a little different. I think that you could probably do this for Valentine's Day. It would really look nice in red. And if you found a form that was like a heart-shaped, then that would really be cute. You could probably give it to like a teacher to hang on the door, since it's a really inexpensive project. The streamers are not, you know, that pricey. I did use the streamers from Walmart, and I used a pack and a half. So it came one streamer in a pack, and I think it was like 97 cents. And then I used a half of another pack. I did get another pack of a different color at, I think, the Party Supply, something like that, and it came two in a pack, but the spool was a little smaller, so in that pack, you would probably use both spools. I also sprayed this with some glitter spray. I don't know if you can see it. It's a little bit shimmery with the silver. That's why I like the silver in the bow. It kind of, you know, gives it a little shimmer with that sparkle. It's not a glue spray. It's just a glitter spray. I don't know. I've used it since like I was a young girl. It was like a running joke with friends when we would have craft night and we'd do something and we'd think, well, it looks great, but you know what? And we called it the treatment. We'd say, it needs the treatment. So that was a little running joke. Whenever we did a craft, it always had to have the treatment. So I gave this little wreath the treatment. I'm really satisfied with it. I like it a lot. I think I'm going to put either one of the hooks on the back that have the teeth, or I might just get a silver door hanger and then hook it on there, and the silver will coordinate with that. You could also probably put like some rhinestones in the center or some pearls in the center of the flower. I happen to just like it kind of subdued and plain, but it would probably look cute if you gave it like a little stamen in the middle of the little flower. It did take a while. I don't suggest children do this with the hot glue gun. You must use glue dots. I burned myself like severely several times doing this, although it does look cute, so I guess it was worth it.